Hello, I'm Dr. Young. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we are going to review what a monopoly is, how to spot it, and five common causes of monopoly power. A monopoly is a market structure in which a firm is the sole seller of a product without close substitutes. Because of this limited competition, the monopolist enjoys a substantial degree of market power, which is defined as the ability to easily alter market prices. This sounds like a simple definition, but it's hard to apply in practice. Suppose that there is only one pencil producer in the world. Would that be considered a monopoly? Let's look back at our definition. The pencil producer is the sole producer of the product in question. A pencil and a pen are both writing tools, though, but are they similar enough to be considered close substitutes? How close is close enough to limit the pencil producer's market power? Economists often use the cross-price elasticity of demand to determine whether a product has close substitutes. This measures how reactive the demand for a good is to changes in the price of a different product. DuPont Corporation was accused of being a monopolist on the cellophane market, as virtually the only producer. However, it claimed that the relevant market should also include other wrapping products, such as aluminum foil or waxed paper. Once those products were considered, DuPont only controlled 17% of the wrapping products market, hardly a dominant position capable of single-handedly altering market prices. The main categories of monopoly power are exclusive control over crucial inputs, intellectual property like patents, network economies, licenses or franchises, and economies of scale. Some companies might have exclusive control over some important inputs to the production process. For instance, De Beers controls most diamond mines in the world. Therefore, it holds a dominant position in the raw diamond market. However, exclusive control over inputs is not a guarantee of a permanent monopoly, because culture changes and technological innovation can devise ways to do without scarce and expensive inputs. Most countries incentivize innovation by granting patents to whoever discovers a new product or process. A patent confers to its holder the exclusive right to the economic benefits involving the invention to which it applies for a limited amount of time. In other words, it grants inventors a temporary monopoly over their inventions. Some products or services acquire value when a lot of people use them. For instance, it would be silly to be the first person with a telephone. You can't use it as a communication tool if nobody else has it. In this way, network economies are of primary importance in the technology industry, and of course, the internet economy. In some markets, suppliers need license to set up shop. In other cases, it is simply a matter of location. Only approved vendors can open a store in an airport or a college campus. That can generate some level of market power, which is why prices are usually higher in those venues. A brand can also sell exclusive access to its logo and products to firms in a given local area, giving those suppliers a local monopoly over their products. This is called a franchise agreement. For some production processes, the average cost of producing a single unit of a product decreases with total quantity produced. This can be due to different factors. Workers learn on the job, and the prices of inputs can be negotiated when you buy large quantities. A common source of economies of scale is the presence of high capital costs. This is the case when you need costly equipment to be able to set up a production process. Economies of scale are among the most important sources of monopoly power because, unlike the other causes we have seen, they are not temporary and tend to be present over a long time. So that's a basic overview of monopolies. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.